Welcome to this week's SNPit. This is where we get down and dirty on a specific topic. And today's topic, motion sickness. I'm Dr. Ben Lynch, and this is the Dirty Genes Podcast. So let's say you've been struggling maybe on a Ferris wheel when you were growing up, going to the playgrounds and the parks and the carnivals, or roller coasters, or car rides going to the roller coasters, or maybe your uncle had a boat and you wanted to go out fishing with them and you get on the boat and things just didn't go very well. Or you wanted to go dancing or ice skating and you started spinning in circles. How did all that work out for you? So for me, I didn't do well in any of those. I still don't. And just last week, I realized why. But I want to share a story, a couple of them. One, I got a direct message from a lady on Instagram. I happened to see hers, and she stated, "Hey, why does my kid always get headaches, but only in the car?" And I was thinking, well, what could that be? And it's motion sickness. One of the signs and symptoms of motion sickness is headaches, along with a myriad of others, but motion sickness is a common problem. And it's something that we all need to know that we have. And if you understand which genes are dirty, which contribute to worsening of your motion sickness, or possibly even bettering it, if you clean those particular genes, then you're onto something. So when I was in Costa Rica, my son decided to organize a trip, and I like to, you know, empower my oldest son, Taz, to, you know, to choose some adventures to put the family through. And so he wanted to go check out this island and go snorkel around this island. And, you know, unbeknownst to him, it was 40 miles offshore to go see this island. And it was pouring rain and the seas were insane. And the boat was long and narrow and we were getting tossed everywhere. And we did not eat, well, I didn't eat breakfast because I knew motion sickness for me was a problem. I was okay. Theo, my youngest, struggled a little bit, but not too bad. And then there's this guy behind us, let's call him Ralph, and he was hurting badly. I mean, awful. He was retching and feeding the fish almost, well, I'd say halfway there, and almost all the way back. And when we finally got to the beach, he just drug himself off the boat, laid back in the UV 13 in the sunshine, didn't care if the sun was gonna burn him, and he was toasted. Why did that happen? And I looked at him and I was like, "Man, I'm sorry you're going through this. What happened?" And he goes, "Well, I'm known to have motion sickness, but not this bad. And what I think did it is I have acid reflux." And I was like, "Oh, okay, check mark to a pathway I'm gonna be quizzing you on in a second. Check mark for acid reflux contributing to motion sickness." And he goes, "And I had a big glass of orange juice and a banana that was in the waiting room of the tour agency before we got on the boat." So this tour agency was kind enough to offer everyone free bananas and free orange juice prior to getting on their boat ride. But what they failed to understand is both of those significantly increase seasickness in their customer base. And so I happened to approach the owner who was on our boat when we got to the beach. And I said, "Hey man, I just want to let you know that you should change your snacks in your waiting room to not include such high, what is it? What do you think? High histamine containing foods and drinks." Yes, exactly. So histamine, once again, is a culprit. So a little trivia, if you will, pigs do not get seasick. Yeah, and why is that? Pigs have an incredible ability to process histamine. And that makes sense, right? They basically eat trash. They eat decomposing, rotting food and no problem. So we're not pigs. We do not have that ability to process histamine in such a great amount. And some of us really struggle with that. So this guy, acid reflux is a high histamine problem. So if you take something to reduce the histamine, it will probably help your acid reflux. In fact, some of the common over-the-counter antacids are antihistamines, and they block the histamine receptors in the stomach for binding histamine. And what is Dramamine? Dramamine is a very famous drug that is used by people going out on boats or who have motion sickness. And what is Dramamine? Dramamine specifically targets the H1 receptor. So the histamine 1 receptor, which is located in many places in your body, but heavily in your brain. So what happens is when you take Dramamine, you swallow it, and then that Dramamine binds to your histamine receptor, so histamine can't bind to it. So if histamine cannot bind to the histamine receptor, no action gets taken. And if histamine is everywhere in your body and you take Dramamine, you're not going to feel the effects of your histamine. But as soon as that Dramamine wears off, what's going to happen? Histamine is going to bind to that receptor and you're going to get motion sickness. So what do you think is the ultimate solution here for improving yourself? Would it be to take and swallow Dramamine or Benadryl all the time or antacids all the time? No, it would be identifying the reason why your histamine levels are so high. And yes, genetics can be a part of it, but what also could be a significant part of it is you could be stressed out. Why? Because stress increases the production of histamine. Infections increase the production of histamine. Exercise increases the production of histamine. So let's say that you went to the gym or you played soccer or you did something very active and you looked at yourself in the mirror before you got in the shower and you had this crazy red face and people were commenting, "Guy, you know, Sally, what is up with your face? Scott, why are you so red-faced? Ben, what is the heck is going on with you, man? Your face is just cherry red." And I was like, "Yeah, I get that way when I exercise." Well, and half an hour later, it's still cherry red. You got some significantly high histamine. And so let me give you a little trick. If you are going to go on a boat or you're going to do something that has to do with motion and a circular or weird movement, roll up your sleeve just like this and take your fingers and then scratch your arm. And I'm not crazy so you draw blood, but it's solid enough. I'm pushing pretty darn hard and I'm scratching right now, okay? And it hurts and I'm looking for red streaks. And I'm not seeing any red streaks really on my arm. So my histamine levels are pretty good right now. I see a little redness through the black fur on my arm, but it's not bad. So what did I find out for me that contributes to my histamine intolerance in a big way, especially motion sickness? So for example, just an hour ago or so, I was in the car with my wife and she drives and I have my phone and I'm on my phone checking some emails or some Instagram messages because I'm trying to be productive. And our roads around here are just twisty-turvy like crazy. And I'm starting to feel off every single time. It doesn't matter what. And so I just have to put the phone down. I can't be productive in the car. I just feel off. I feel nauseated and it lasts for hours. I took a helicopter tour with my family in Kauai. It was beautiful. Kauai was stunning. My family loved it. I loved it until the motion sickness was so bad that I had to lay down for basically the rest of the day. I was incapacitated. So what I did is I did my genes through StrateGene and I looked at the histamine pathway and most of my histamine genes are actually quite clean. Most of my histamine genes are born clean. So my DAO gene, and the DAO, as you've probably read in the book, Dirtygenes, is associated with breaking down histamine from food and drink and from the microbiome. That gene was clean. It was born clean. No problems there. My HNMT gene, which breaks down histamine in the brain and a lot of other places in the body, it was also fine. But the gene that was really big on me, that was fast and super sensitive, was, you ready? We discussed it already. Dramamine blocks it, the H1 receptor. My H1 histamine receptor is off the charts overly sensitive. So my ability to bind histamine on my H1 receptor is hot, too hot. So if I have a little bit of histamine compared to you and I get in a car or I got on a boat, I'm in trouble. So I have to do everything in my power not to increase my histamine levels. A, keep my stress levels down. B, hydrate. Water, you've got to be hydrating. If you do not hydrate, then your histamine concentration in your blood could increase. So in hydrating, remember, it's not just drinking water, it's getting water into your cell. So consider optimal electrolytes from Seeking Health to support getting water into your cell. Because if you just drink water and then 15 minutes you're peeing it out, you've got some electrolyte deficiencies. So you have to replenish electrolytes, and optimal electrolyte may support you on that. So I have to hydrate, and I drink water all the time when on a boat. Alcohol is a huge problem. And what do people drink when they go on boats? They drink alcohol, beer, wine, and other alcohol. And what else do they eat? Cheese, and also old aged meats. So think back in the old sailor days. They had lots of wine, they had lots of cheese, and they had lots of fermented meats, and they had oranges for preventing scurvy and possibly some other things. And so all that is high histamine. So those poor sailors, if they were struggling with H1 sensitivity like me, they probably weren't actually sailors. They probably quit their job or they were thrown overboard and lost their job. So if you are struggling with motion sickness, I really invite you to consider ordering StrateGene, the genetic test, and you can look at to see which genes of yours were born dirty, and you can evaluate them. Maybe it's a DAO gene, and you got to really dial in and not be taking probiotics that increase histamine, like Lactobacillus bulgaricus, or Lactobacillus fermentum, or Lactobacillus casei. Maybe you back off on the yogurt, you back off on the cheese, you back off on the foods that you know are problematic for you that cause, you know, intolerant reactions like gluten or dairy. You back off. You don't eat those. Hydrating, not drinking alcohol on the boats, anywhere, you know, that is going to be with motion. And then supporting your methylation pathway is another big one. We'll get into that later. But read the DAO chapter in the book, Dirty Genes. That will help you as well. So it's very, very handy to know what your histamine genes are doing in your own body, because then you know exactly what you need to do to dial in to try to figure it out. So next time you are struggling with motion sickness, know that histamine is a big, big culprit, and do everything in your power to knock down that histamine. And keep in mind, histamine also increases alertness and focus. So if you're taking Benadryl or Dramamine and you want to have fun during the day, whale watching or what have you, these things may actually put you to sleep on the boat and you're going to be missing all the fun. So you might want to be considering looking at supplements that support histamine intolerance, because you can support the degradation of histamine without having it affect your mood or your focus as much. So I hope that serves you. Go ahead and give it a like, thumbs up, and share and comment if you can. So take care until the next time. Keep those genes clean, and I hope the motion sickness for you goes away, because it is not fun. Take care.